Good morning, everyone. Could I have everyone's attention, please? Our service is about to commence shortly, so could you please ensure that your mobile phones are switched off or at least on silent as a respect for the family? That would be fantastic. Thank you. We won't keep you too long. Before we commence this service, I've just been asked to make an announcement. If anyone owns a white ute with a number plate starting with DZK, could you please move your vehicle as it is impeding someone from getting into doing their job? Has anyone here got a white ute? No? Well, it must be somewhere else then. One moment. To start this service, I would like to invite Melissa to please come forward to light a special remembrance candle, especially for Jeanette. Thank you. Well, good morning and a very warm welcome to you all. We've gathered here today to celebrate the life of Jeanette Eleanor Rogers and to express our love and our admiration for her. We are also here to try and bring some consolation and comfort to you, her family, and all of her friends who have been saddened by her passing. Now, my name is Louise Spedding, and I'm so very honoured to be leading this service today. Now, on behalf of the family, I'd like to pass on their appreciation to everyone for the thoughtfulness and care that you have given to them at this very difficult time in their lives. They thank everyone for travelling to be here with them and for offering comfort to them in their grief. They also thank those who unfortunately could not be here today and welcome those who are joining us via the internet, and everyone's support and their kindness is so greatly appreciated. The family also wish to thank and acknowledge all of Jeanette's medical team for their kind and caring attention giving to Jeanette during her illness and for looking after her so well, especially all the wonderful, compassionate nurses from Mona Vale Palliative Care for not only their excellent care, but for also their friendship. Now, as with any funeral service, we gather to mourn a departed loved one, pay tribute to their achievements and their life, comfort one another, and give our support to one another. Now, these are not enough to soften the blow of the experience of death. We can experience a wide range of emotions: anger, pain, hurt, sorrow, and grief. But there are some things that cannot be taken away, and that is the experience of loving and the experience of friendship. Now, Jeanette had so many different friendships on her journey through life, and she valued each of them, and no two were quite the same. So when we lose someone dear to us, the hurt can be almost unbearable, yet somehow we seem to get through it. Although this will not be easy, here today, as we share in a common bond of love and friendship, let us try just for a little while to put aside our sorrow and instead think about the memories and joy that Jeanette has given, received, and shared with you all. Although Jeanette is no longer physically present, nothing can change your love for her or her love for you. Let the special part that she played in your lives endure. Today we say farewell to a wonderful woman, and she will be forever right here in your hearts. Now, Jeanette was an adored and adoring mother to Scott and Melissa, and mother-in-law to Becky. A cherished nana to Albie, Leland, and Teddy. A much-loved daughter to parents Bert and Joan Rogers, and a loving younger sister to Chris and Pam. Jeanette was also a respected sister-in-law and auntie and a dear friend to many, and she will be sadly missed by all who knew her. Now, in her last days, Jeanette's thoughts were not for herself, but for her loved ones, especially her children and her grandchildren. She wanted to know that they were okay, but it was time for her to let go and find peace. And when she passed, she was holding three small little heart-shaped pillows that her three grandchildren had given to her, which gave her so much comfort. And those hearts are with her still. But today we're going to celebrate Jeanette's life in the way that she would want to be remembered, by listening to some great music, hearing some special memories, and watching a photo presentation of her life. So when a family member or friend passes away, whether it's sudden or not, it causes each of us to take a step back and reflect upon the times that we've all shared with them. It is a reminder that on this journey that we all share, living each moment is most important. Everyone will have their own memories and recollections of Jeanette, and today, in particular, is a day that all those memories will come flooding back. So to tell you a little bit about Jeanette, she was born on the 16th of December 1957 in her grandparents' home in North Willoughby, and along with her parents and her sisters lived in Forestville. Her school years were spent at Forestville Primary School, followed by Forest High. And upon leaving school, Jeanette enrolled in Secretarial College and went on to work as a secretary and office administrator. During her working career, she was employed by MacKellar County Council, the NRMA at both the DY and Warringamore branches, followed by working for Granite Transformations in Brookvale. Now, Jeanette was a funny, bright and bubbly person who was outgoing and adventurous. And apparently she could be a little bit stubborn at times. I think that's true by all that reaction. She enjoyed travelling and was always available to go on holidays with you if you needed a travel companion. Jeanette also enjoyed playing golf and was a member of the Asquith Magpies Ladies Golf Club. And when she wasn't playing golf, she would often go on social outings with them. But most of all, Jeanette loved her family, especially her grandchildren, and would regularly take them to school, to the movies, to play footy, fishing, and quite often had them for sleepovers. She regarded herself as a grandmother above all else, and she was so, so very proud to be their nana. So we're now going to hear from Jeanette's children, Scott and Melissa, who will pay tribute to their mum with some personal stories. And you may feel like smiling or laughing as you recall these happy times, and I do think this would be Jeanette's wish. So, Scott and Melissa, would you like to come forward?
Ladies and gentlemen, today we gather to celebrate the life of a wonderful woman, a beloved daughter, sister, mother, nana, and friend, Jeanette Eleanor Rogers. Born in 1957 to parents Joan and Bert, Mum came into the world at her grandmother's home in North Willoughby. Growing up alongside her sisters, Chris and Pam, she cherished the bonds of family and learned the values of love, loyalty, and resilience. Her journey through education had her start at the local Forestville Primary School to Forest High School and then on to Technical School for Secretarial Studies, where she honoured her skills that would carry her through the many organisations she worked at in her life.
In her youth, Mum found joy in playing netball and touch football, where she made lifelong friends and relationships. Through her life, she was involved in many sporting clubs surrounding her children's pursuits, including swimming, football, nippers, cricket, where she would become part of the club's ethos, helping and contributing every which way she could, and once again, forming lifelong friendships. In 2000, on the invite of her sister Pam, her and Chris joined the Asquith Ladies Social Golf Club in their inaugural year, playing through until last year. A fun memory I've got is taking Mum down to the local pro shop and getting a brand new set of golf clubs fitted to suit her.
Towards the end of the year last year, on Mum's suggestion, Mum, Scott, the boys and I went and played putt-putt and let the boys hit some balls on the driving range. It was a wonderful day. I'm not sure who loved it more, her or the boys.
At the age of 26, Mum welcomed her son, Scott, into the world, followed by her daughter, Melissa, age 36. We were obviously the light of a life, never a hassle, and always just perfect in every way. Although most of you know this is definitely not the case. She loved us and cared for us and protected us. As though it was true.
From the time I was born, you were always protecting me in any and every way you could, which is something I will miss the most. There are a lifetime of memories I will hold deep in my heart, and today I will share a few. I remember you telling me about the night I was born and everyone came to visit. Everyone gathered around and watched the State of Origin on your small hospital TV, something special which became our tradition for many years to come, especially on my 18th birthday.
Her generosity knew no bounds. Her willingness to help others, especially her family, was unparalleled. She was there for you through thick or thin, always ready to offer a helping hand or a big hug. Her love knew no bounds, and her legacy of loyalty will continue through us and her grandchildren.
Your words of encouragement never failed to push me to strive for better. I always knew you were in my corner, backing me and believing in me.
Do you want to just start here?
You worked long hours to ensure you could always provide for us, and I would return the favour by falling asleep in my high chair before I could be fed. A small symbol of the humour we would always share with my ability to fall asleep anywhere. As I grew older, this habit faded and turned into you stroking my forehead. Something so simple but peaceful that allowed me to rest.
She had an adventurous spirit, always eager to explore the new destinations with her family and friends. As mentioned in Chris and Pam's sentiments later, she was eager to travel to just about anywhere. In fact, she was already planning her next trip with me, Melissa, Becky and the boys to create more cherished memories.
Travelling was something you always did love, and I will forever be grateful for all the holidays and trips we went on. Although I would nag, "Are we there yet?" you still made every trip fun and memorable. Every school holidays was a new destination, a different caravan park, and was always so much fun. We took a trip to Western Australia to visit Scott and travelled down to the Margaret River. Doing this together is something I will never forget.
Upon retiring, Mum embraced the chapter of her life that brought her the most happiness, the one of nannahood. Her three grandsons, Albert, Leland and Edward, brought immeasurable happiness into her world. From sleepovers to catch-ups, from pickups to FaceTimes, she cherished every moment spent with them, sharing them with hugs, kisses and endlessly spoiling them. They were her world.
I was privileged enough to bless you with another grandson. He was an angel in your eyes, forever being spoiled. The time he spent with his nana, I know he will never forget. It's hard for him to comprehend just what has happened and why, but I know he will be reminded daily of the legacy you leave behind. He, along with Albie and Teddy, gave you the strength to continue fighting through your battle.
As Louise mentioned before, in the Mernavale Palliative Care Unit, the boys each chose a small, coloured, heart-shaped pillow to give Mum. She held the three hearts tight in her fist, checking they were still there as she slowly passed. They were with her at the end, and they're with her now. She was not just a nana to them, she was the epitome of unconditional love and support.
Scott and I will be forever grateful of you, Mum, with your determination and courage through this difficult time. As we gather here with you today, I hope you are now at peace and no longer in pain. I thank you for always being there to protect me, guide me, giving me advice, a sounding board to vent, and sometimes just a hug to fix all my problems. Mum, I will forever hold you in my heart.
Mum never subscribed to an idea of heaven or an afterlife, so her enduring presence resides solely within our memories. The laughter, love, and moments we hold dear, as she rests in peace, we must hold on to these treasured memories so that she remains a vibrant part of all of our lives forever. Thank you.
Thank you. thank you both so very much for sharing those stories with us. I do know that Jeanette would be so proud of you two right now. And so, excuse me, I'd now like to read some special tributes to Jeanette from her sisters, Chris and Pam. Firstly, from Chris, "Nett, my baby sister, a devoted mum and nana, she loved and cherished her special times with her grandboys. Just like our mum, she could be feisty and a fighter. These traits, along with her positive attitude, helped her fight so hard for so long as she did. Something to be admired. At peace now and will suffer no more. She is dearly missed by us all. A special thank you to Mona Vale Palliative Care team for their genuine care and compassion they gave to Nett and to all the family. Love, Chris." And now from Pam. "My beautiful little sister Nett, you were my go-to girl, my sounding board for all sorts of things, big kids, little kids, where our next holiday was, or something like coming up and going to lunch and staying the weekend. Tony and I always look forward to your visits. You know, we solved world peace several times once at the hairdressers. They were funny times. And many times on the phone at night, we chatted for hours. We worked out who should be running the country and who shouldn't. We just talked shit for hours sometimes, and it was great. We had a great life growing up, and many friends were our friends. We took up golf, and I got Nett and Chris to join Asquith Ladies Golf Club. She was keen and quite often got the longest drive. We had some good weekends away with the ladies playing golf. We had some fantastic camping and caravan holidays with all the kids and friends. I think we did nearly all of the New South Wales East Coast over the years. They were good times. You, Chris, and I had a great time in England, Ireland, Scotland, and Wales. Then a trip to Hawaii. She really enjoyed that. This is where she found her love of turtles after swimming with them. She absolutely loved it. One of our last trips was to Uluru with our cousins Donna and Heather. She loved this too. Dinner in the desert, the field of lights, bush tucker with Mark Olive. Now, a little side story about the Uluru trip. It was about 40 degrees and we went for a swim in a nice cold pool. But the ground was so hot, as she ran across the red hot cement, she did an unintentional bomb into the pool. Water went everywhere, including up the backsides of some very hot sunbaking German tourists who screamed like something had bitten them. I just had to turn away laughing my head off. It was the funniest thing, and she only realised after she'd heard the screams. Now, she loved us all, her kids, her beautiful grandsons, all her family, and we just loved her back. She inspired and encouraged me to do all sorts of things. One of her most recent encouragements was to get a puppy called Bert. She was a very, very special sister and a special person. I'm so lucky to have had her as my sister and a friend. And of course, someone to talk a bunch of shit to. I love her and I miss her. With love, Pam." So thank you so much, Chris and Pam, for sharing these stories, and it was my absolute privilege to read it on your behalf. So it's now time to pause for a little while, to reflect and to recall the experiences and the relationships that you all shared with Jeanette. Now, each of you will have your own special memories, which will grow stronger each day as the enormous feelings of grief, loss and sorrow that you are now experiencing diminish. So I ask that you now all take a moment's silence to reflect and to remember a special memory that you've all shared with Jeanette, and have a little smile to yourself and just keep that thought with you. So this is also a time to pray if you choose. Thank you. Now, at times when you least expect it, something will occur which will bring Jeanette back to you so vividly and clearly. A place, a song, a saying, a smell, a thought. In this way, Jeanette will live on and she will always remain a part of you. So we're now going to see some pictures, some memories of Jeanette's life, and you may see yourselves in some of these photos and recall the happy times that you shared with her.
Early morning, there's a message on my phone. It's my mother saying, darling, please come home. I fear the worst, but how could you leave us all behind? There's so much to say, but there's so little time. So how do I say goodbye? Someone who's been with for my whole damn life. You gave me my name and the color of your eyes. I see your face when I look at mine. So how do I say goodbye? When I couldn't, you always saw the best in me. Right or wrong, you were always on my side. But I'm scared of what life without you's like. And I saw the way she looked into your eyes. And I promise if you go, I will make sure she's alright. So how do I say goodbye? Someone who's been with me for my whole damn life. You gave gonna steal some time and start again. You'll always be my closest friend. And someday we're gonna make it out. Just hold the light. Just hold the light high, high. So how do I say goodbye?
Someone... You took my hand, you showed me how. You promised me you'd be around. That's right. I took your words and I believed in everything you said to me. Yeah, that's right. Who knew?
We've got some amazing photos and memories there that you'll be able to...
morning, there's a message on my phone.
Oh, it's replaying. Well, I've got a few extra steps in then. Yes, as I was saying, you know, through those photos you've got wonderful memories to cherish forever. And, you know, it is important to continue to retell the stories and the memories that you all have of Jeanette, because even though she's no longer with us, she still travels a journey with you, and she will always, always be a part of all of your stories. So in honour of Jeanette and on behalf of the family, I'd now like to read this very special poem. It's titled One of a Kind, and the author is Robin O'Connell. You really were one of a kind, like the rarest type of gem. Your family can't begin to thank you for the influence that you had on them. You taught them how to make a home to help their children grow. Teaching by your example was the greatest way to know. As a nana, you were loved. You could not have wished for more. Everyone loved that warm smile that you had when you greeted them at the door. Come in, you'd say, and immediately the slice that did come out. No one could ever leave hungry. Of this there was no doubt. Your body was becoming tired, and we know it was for the best. You overcame so many obstacles. You really deserve a rest. Please take with you all of our love and give it to those gone before. We will never forget you. Our love will last forevermore. Well, now, as this service draws to an end, remember that the loss of Jeanette cannot be removed or healed in a moment, but Jeanette's loving memory will forever live on in your hearts. So on behalf of Anne Rawson Funerals and myself, we'd like to thank the family for entrusting us with Jeanette's care. Following the service, you are all warmly invited to the Lone Pine Lookout for some refreshments and to share some of your personal stories of Jeanette with each other. Now, the function will commence at midday, so before then, you are welcome to relax at the dugout, which is just over here. And now, could I please ask if you are able to be upstanding in honour of Jeanette? So Jeanette, this is not a goodbye, but a thank you. Thank you for your love and your friendship and for the memories which will always remain. And most of all, thank you for being you. You definitely leave this world a richer place than you found it, and you will be greatly missed. So we leave you now in peace, and with the utmost respect, we bid you farewell. You will always be loved, never forgotten, and forever missed. May you now rest in peace as you travel amongst the stars. Our funeral director will now step forward to accompany Jeanette out of the chapel. And as the final song plays, please follow the family outside to bid Jeanette farewell, where you will have the opportunity to place some beautiful roses onto her coffin. Thank you.
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough. And things go wrong no matter what I do. Now and then it seems like life is just too much. But you've got the love I need to see me through. When food is gone, you are my daily need. Oh. When friends are gone, I know my Savior's love is real. You know it's real. You got the love. 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 Time after time, I think, oh Lord, what's the use? Time after time, I think it's just no good. 'Cause sooner or later in life, the things you love, you lose. But you've got the love I need to see me through. You got the love. Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through. Sometimes it seems the going is just too rough. To see me through. You got the love.